where we thought we scored against Toronto with 3 seconds left. 8 seconds is still a lot of time. The faceoff will be all important here as Jason Cerrone gets instructions from Brent Loney. Faceoff will go to the left of Rick Tabaracci once they line it up again. Maltese, Cerrone up front, Schneider and Babcock on defense in front of Tabaracci. The four horsemen, the four workhorsemen for the Royals in this period. 67s. There are six players stream off the bench. Griffith, Binney, Lado East, Castles, and Greg Walters. Well, if Jason Cerrone ever wanted to win a big faceoff, he's got a chance here against Andrew Castles with 8 seconds to go, Cornwall 4 and Ottawa 3 in this game 6 of the Leyden Division semifinal. Royals are that close. Linesman Steve Corleone will set it down between Castles and Cerrone. It's down. And Cerrone steals it, shoots it down the ice. It is in. The Royals win it. The Royals are headed to the OHL Leyden Division Championship Series for the first time ever in their 8-year history in the Ontario Hockey League. Jason Cerrone with the hat trick, winning the faceoff from Andrew Castles, then taking the puck away from Troy Binney, shooting it down the ice into the empty net. That's all she wrote. 2 seconds on the clock. The Royals move on. It will be unassisted, his 11th of the playoffs. And everybody back home, of course, saying, Fred, what are you so excited for? You predicted the Royals would win in six. I know. Just like I predicted a six-game series against the Marlies. Well, a mere formality at center ice. The puck is down, and the Cornwall Royals stream off the bench. For the veterans on this team, this is a very emotional moment. Knocking the 67s out of the playoffs, a team that has ended the Royals season the last 2 years. 5-3, the final score. Royals say, bring on the Peace. We'll come back with Royals replay for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we wish the Cornwall Royals. short side. Here's Berry for Canada. Into Sherbin. Centered Rothschild there to intercept. And here's Perdita. Head manning it on right wing. Trying to carry in is Uvira. And Chalapsky tying him up. Now pulls him down. He gave one a little tug too many. Now gets the penalty. Delayed penalty, and now as Sherbin gets possession, play called, and Canada will be shorthanded. Canada leads 2-1. We'll be right back.
First Gillette made Atra with a pivoting head. Now there's Atra Plus to make it smoother. Advanced lubricants in a white LubriSmooth strip are released to deliver Gillette's closest, most comfortable shave ever. Atra Plus from Gillette, the essence of shaving.
Personally, I've always admired his use of yellow.
His merging of abstract shapes and a multi-hued palette is one of the joys of our time.
Yes, his subtle shading, his sensitivity to the gray spectrum.
A stroke work of a Rembrandt.
Oh, it's so thrilling to see the new IBM Personal System 2 in the hands of an old master.
Balderdash.
The new IBM Personal System 2, advancing the art of business.
Charlie Zalapsky gets a holding penalty for Canada, 16-19 the time.
Well, Shel Lynn let this go, and he let it go, and he let it go, and finally he says, all right, that's enough of that.
But Zalapsky wouldn't let go.
Yeah, that's it. There were two or three times there he could have called it. Shel Lynn is being a little generous in this game and in some of the holding and so on, but once the man was down, he had to call it. It's interference all the way behind the net.
Canada clearing it down the ice. Here's Paynock, number 9. Leaves it for Leba. Leba trying to stick handle up. Does, gets it into center ice, and here's Toshek. Got around one man, but Randy Gregg is there to break it up and clear it back up. And then a body check that Paynock tried to throw. Goes Sheik back to get it for Czechoslovakia. He feeds Sheba. Leaving it for Toshek. Now to number 9, Paynock ahead to Toshek. Back on the point. Return to Toshek again. Canada in that box formation to try and kill it off. Here at the point, they work it into Leba again. Fired in front, deflected by Sheba, but it went just wide. Now Paynock lost it. Leba couldn't get it, and Schreiber able to clear it out of there. Here's Bosheek. The number 9, Paynock. 48 seconds left in the penalty to Canada. Good play by Randy Gregg to break it up and clear it down the ice. Now we're going to get a penalty over in front of the Team Canada bench. And I believe Igor Leba has been nailed. Leba, by the way, is the guy that sent Cliff Fletcher, the Calgary GM, an invitation to his wedding. Fletcher didn't accept. Well, he wants to play for the Flames.
Here's the penalty right here. Leba pulls him down. Maybe if he had sent airfare, he might have gone.
I said to Cliff, I said, but did you send a gift?
You tell Cliff is a little lukewarm on Igor Leba. He drafted him, but he's not really been too aggressive in his pursuit of Leba, not in the way he has been with Radina. Well, Radina was pretty aggressive in his own right. He went to see Cliff at the Calgary Cup last year.
The Flames, by the way, have NHL rights to 5 players on this team. Radina, Staviana, Paynock, Rochal, and Leba. Now each team a man short. Zalapsky with 32 seconds left. When he returns, Canada will have the man advantage. Here's Trentiani. Firing it ahead for Bradley. Now Boisvert digs in, and they're going to call icing on the play. Each team a man short of the faceoff. Look in on Dave King at Canada's bench.
Well, the fans are here. Want that bronze, at least. Last time Canada beat Czechoslovakia in the Olympics was 1968. That was the game I was telling you about, Dan, where they had those glass boards around the arena in Grenoble, and Jackie McLeod with Czechoslovakia just pouring in on Ken Broderick, who was in goal for Canada. They kicked one of the panels of the boards. I never forget it. Just kind of flew out onto the ice, this great big monstrous 10-foot panel. It took about 20 minutes to get the thing back in, remounted and set, And by that time, Czechoslovakia had cooled off and they weren't a factor in the game the rest of the way. McLeod will never admit he did it. Neither did the players, but somebody kicked it loose. Just cooled him right off.
Here's Sherbon. Round on the boards to Staviana. Now Zalapski back on, so Canada on a power play, but Block has the puck for Czechoslovakia. Dropping it into his own zone for Sherbon. Over to Staviana. A minute eight left in the penalty to Leva of Czechoslovakia. So Canada leading 2-1 on a power play with 1:20 left here in the first period. Wabir feeding it ahead for Barry number 9. Back to Felix. Felix takes the shot, moves in deeper, gives it to Barry. Side of the net to Bradley.
Last minute of play.
Back on the point. Roy drive just wide. Bradley behind the net. To Felix, moves in, shoots, hit the side of the net. Chris Felix. Back to Barry. Over to Roy. Return to Barry. Barry shooting, he scores! Deflected in, I believe, by Chris Felix, number 23.
Terrific power play. Lots of puck control. They kept hustling, getting the puck back, and finally, with a real traffic jam in front of the net, Ken Barry let it go. We'll have to take a look at the replay to see who deflected it. Barry's number 9. Here comes the puck. He'll unload it. See where it changes direction. It may have gone all the way. It looked like it may have gone off the blocker of the goaltender and into the net. But it did change direction because it came into the net in a different direction. So I think Barry's going to get credit for this one.
Barry does get the goal. A power play goal at 19-18. Chris Felix will get an assist. As will Brian Bradley. And Canada cash in on a power play opportunity and have a 3-1 lead as Canada attempts to keep its slim bronze medal hopes alive. They must win this game today to do that. Here's Beinock dumping it in. Laplinski back to get it. Able to clear it down the ice. Beinock going back for Czechoslovakia. In there, trying to steal it. Malinowski in front to Karpin. And a save by Hasek, and then Karpin got another poke at it, and it went just wide. Karpin and Poplinski jam up with three players from Czechoslovakia. There's Jim Poplinski, the native of Renfrew, Ontario, who, of course, is on loan here to the Olympic team from the Calgary Flames.
And there's Ken Berry, who's a veteran of the 1980 Olympic team. Back for another shot.
Watch Hasek in the goal. Look, he's standing straight up. He's looking. See where he's leaning? He's looking. He can't find out where that puck's coming. A great screen in front of the net. See, look at him. He's looking. He can't find that puck. And that's where that defenseman, if you're going to shoot the puck from the point, you put that guy in front of it. That's a perfect example of a goaltender having a lot of problems. It creates so much problems for the goaltender and for the defense.
That's when the defenseman's got to try and move him out of there if he can.
5 seconds left in the period. Canada leading 3-1. Faceoff deep in Czechoslovakia's end of the rink. Mark Hapscheid wins the draw, but cleared out, and here's a break for Poshak. But time may run out. He shot wide anyway, just as the buzzer went to end the period. And Andy Moe says thank God for little things like the buzzers.
Well, Poshak knew what the clock read. He knew he didn't have much time. He wasn't going to try a Bobby Russo and put it in from center ice. He just simply knew that he had to let it go and let it go early. And he let it go and missed the net.
Canada leads after one period. 3-1 over Czechoslovakia. Let's go right here to Dan Matheson.
Thanks very much, Dan Kelly. Of course, we will return with live coverage of the second period. One update, one gold medal has been won today already. Gunde Svan of Sweden won gold in the men's 50K cross-country ski race. Another gold on the line right now at Nikiska. That is where we will go next when we come back live on CTV.
Chris Felix, and Felix plays it off the boards. Down into Czechoslovakia's end of the rink. That's going to be icing against Canada. Canada, Roy, Joyce, and Berry have scored. Stop Yana, the only goal for Czechoslovakia.
Well, in the first period, Canada mounted its lead. Here we go, Brad.
There's the shot right wide. It goes by Hasek on the stick side. We thought it might have been tipped by Bovaire, but it didn't look it there. Here's Leva passing out. Staviano moving in right inside the far post on the ice. A perfect shot. But this was the picture play as Bob Joyce split the defense. Now watch Hasek come sliding out, and Joyce just walks around him and slides into the net, making it 2-1.
And then later in the period, Berry scored to make it 3-1. We're just underway with the second period. Canada with Berry trying to chop it out of there. And number 8, Ubira, goes back to get it. Round to Rochal, number 10. Canada with Sherman, centered to Berry. Stick saved there by Hasek. And Czechoslovakia try and carry up ice. This is number 17, Ruzicka. Ahead on right wing, Herdina trying to break in, but Sherbin had him tied up and knocked him down. And then Zalewski clears to Hampshire. Mark Hampshire dumps it in, then Canada change on the fly. And Horsheva back to get it. Trying to clear to Herdina, now to Ruzicka. Ruzicka trying to stick handle through, just tipped by Roy, and Brian Bradley flipped it up. Now Bradley to Schreiber, ahead for Boisvert. Boisvert shoots. Hasek got a piece of that, appeared to injure himself, but he's up and okay. Loose puck at Canada's blue line. Third for Roy, over to Tim Waters. Back to Roy. His shot off the stick of Bochic, wide of the net. This is Bochic, beating it for Flock, number 27. Leaves it for Lala. Shot hit the side of the net. Canada with Trent Yanni coming back to get it. Feeds it out to Schreiber. And it's tipped by Schreiber down into Czechoslovakia's end of the rink. This is Bainok back to get it. Up there forechecking Yaremchuk. Bainok knocked him down. Dell Lynn lets it go, and the fans thought there should have been a penalty. Here's Block. In for Czechoslovakia. Yanni bumps him. Yanni got the worst of that, but continues to battle on the boards. Back is Felix to shoot it out onto the other wing, and Canada clear it out of the zone.
Well, in that first period, Dan, just taking a look at my own score sheet, I kind of score scoring chances, the glittering chances that could and should result with a decent play in a goal. And Canada outchanced Czechoslovakia 7-3.
Here's a chance with Loeb caught out of there. He got a piece of it, and then the Canadian goal is knocked loose as Sheva crashed into it. We'll be right back.
Nowhere on earth but at the Bay will you find savings like this on Bomark Floor Care. Save 25% on all Bomark Floor Care, designed to pick up everything from dirt and fluff to stardust. Don't miss this sensational offer of 25% off Bomark Floor Care, only at the Bay during Flying Colors. A sale so great, it's out of this world.
Welcome back to the Saddle Dome. Face off at Canada's blue line. And Canada leading this game 3-1. Shoot it into the Czechoslovak end of the rink. Firing it out there, and here's a breakaway for Sheva. Scores! Sheva just took the pass at center ice and went in alone on the Canadian goaltender Andy Moog, and Sheva cuts Canada's lead to 3-2.
Well, just before we went on the break, Sheva crashed into the goalpost and appeared to be shaken up. Here he just took the pass straight up the middle, and he's all alone. Nice little move here. Pops it in.
A good little move on Moog. But watch, Sheva, here he comes in. Watch, he's going to go to his right, go back to his left. And Andy Moog, Moog had gone to his left with that first move. But the interesting thing was, you know, when you're a defenseman on the other team's blue line, you got to be responsible for those guys circling out. The only time that you can't be, you don't have to worry about them, is when the other team doesn't have good control of the puck.
Here are the Czechoslovaks again on the attack. Shot blocked. Roy can't get it out of there, though. Rochelle holding it in. Here's Brzezicka behind the net. Roy took him out, and over on the far side is Bradley. Bradley can't get it out of there. Here's Herdina centering one. Over onto these near boards, and then Roy cleared it right up into the bench of Czechoslovakia. The scoring play was Sheba from Leba, 3:46. Quite a pass by Leba, hitting him right at the center ice red line.
Oh, a great pass. This is a real slow-mo action shot. Watch this little detail. It wasn't much, but it was one where you start to lean, the goaltender starts to go with you, and then you plant your foot, you just come back on him. As when somebody's moving that quickly, you can go from one side of the net to the other in an awful hurry, faster than a goaltender can. But Sheba just made a great move. Leva made an unbelievable pass and a mix-up at the blue line by Zalapski and Randy Gregg, because Sheba actually came from Zalapski's side, and he assumed that Randy Gregg was going to pick him up. And Randy Gregg said, I'm working at my side. I'm not going to worry about what's coming from the other side. So just a little mix-up there, but look what happens.
Here's Lala's shot off the blocker of Moog. And back comes Kalinowski for Canada, dumping it in. Hasek sets it up back to the net, and they just clear it right back out to center. Yanni at his own line to Chris Felix. Felix flipped it in, and Canada called it an offside at Czechoslovakia's blue line. A slim 3-2 lead for Canada. We'll be right back.
Sean Mason thinks it's time he learned to ski. And his parents know it's time to start saving for Sean's future. Crown Life showed them how with Head Start, a new savings and insurance plan that gave Sean a head start. Saving for college, for travel, for the day he's ready to soar on the wings of his own dreams. Only Crown Life has Head Start, because it's never too soon to get started.
With Ron Roche and Brad Park, Dan Kelly back at the Saddle Dome. Face off in the center ice area. Canada with a 3-2 lead. Here's Chris Felix shooting the puck down the ice. Barry races in to keep it onside. The Hampshire out in front. They score! Sherman! And it's 4-2 Canada.
Well, the so-called checking line of Team Canada has been a real force in this game. Sherman on a beautiful little pass out, right there, right on the spot.
There's the shoot-in by Felix. Watches. It comes around the far side. Ken Berry has it, chips out. Hapshite jumps out. Now watch how quick this puck gets off of Sherman's stick into the upper corner. A great, he just turned his body into it. It doesn't take long. Boom, one-timed it into the upper corner by Hasek. A very, very pretty goal and a great move by Hapshite to get that puck out to him.
From Gravelberg, Saskatchewan, Gord Sherman gets a big one. And Canada has a two-goal lead again. Sherman from Hampshire and Berry, the scoring play. 4:52 the time. Hampshire again to Zalewski. Shot blocked, now Berry to Hampshire. Over to Sherman, who gets all tied up by Horsheba. And now it's cleared to Rochelle, and he comes to center for Czechoslovakia. Trying to get around Zalewski. Rochelle still tied up by Zalewski, and now Berry took a hit but cleared it out of there. Zalewski races in. Drops it to Sherman. Out in front was Hampshire all alone, but Rochelle broke it up. Now Sherman back at his own line. Sherman, who had that last goal for Canada, moving in. Tried to drop it, but Horsheba broke it up. Rosicka now to Horsheba. He's bumped, but got the pass to Ivera. Sherman ties him up, and back is Roy for Canada. Now Tim Waters ahead to Bob Joyce, but that's going to be called back on a two-line offside pass.
Well, as you look at the bench there, at the goal scorer, Gord Sherman, Hampshire and Berry. I'll tell you, I've watched Berry through two tournaments, 1980 and here. Here's a nice play. As Berry had started this one, a little shot out in front, Sherman just right there. Hampshire set it up. Berry was the third man on the play. I've seen Berry play two tournaments. It's the best game I've seen him play. And I can remember back in 1980, he scored a hat-trick against Holland in an early game in that tournament. But again, then that was Holland. It wasn't the Soviet Union. And he's just been a factor in this game. Very big. Plays a big, I'm sorry, Dan, he plays a big man's game, and he's not a big man.
Here's Canada on the attack again. Boisvert got it in front, but Lala bumps with Boisvert. And then the puck is chipped up over the glass just inside Czechoslovakia's blue line.
There's Serge Boisvert, who is not a big man either. That's one of the problems, of course, Canada has faced. They get big guys who are checkers and little guys who are scorers. It'd be nice to get a big guy who can score and check.
He's only one of those, and he wears number 66.
I'll get the Go Canada Go. We haven't heard that much this week. The fans here in Calgary are very knowledgeable and, of course, very pro-Canada, but not too demonstrative or not too vocal.
Here's a face-off just inside Czechoslovakia's blue line. Hašek and Karpin to take the draw. Karpin got it in, but here's Saviana carrying back up. Saviana feeds it ahead for Sheva. That's offside at Canada's blue line. And Poplinski upends Sheva.
Now there's Sheva. Here's the Sheva, who is a member of this Czechoslovak team since 1985, and Jim Poplinski, who's been a member of Canada's national team for about 2 weeks now. There's Jim's parents on hand from Ontario.
Poplinski is out on the line with Malinowski and Karpin. Buck to the Czechoslovak blue line, Cervon. Trying to feed it up the ice, but knocked down, and back comes Malinowski for Canada, poking it in. Karpin races in to get it. Back of the goal, Cervon. Now Canada's Malinowski for Karpin. Into the other corner, Staviana. And Czechoslovakia in control. Here's Lita, number 11. Misses Staviana with a pass, goes the length of the ice. Canada's Chris Felix back. And that's going to be icing against Czechoslovakia. Canada has a two-goal lead here in the second period. We'll be right back.
In the small northern town of Hudson Bay, Saskatchewan, February is the coldest month of the year. In Calgary, the temperatures may not be much higher, but for Viv and Gord Yawney, seeing their son represent his country is a pretty warming thought.
I think I'll be more nervous than Trent will be on the ice.
It's going to be very, very exciting to see them boys out there.
At one time, we were tying his skates. It's so hard to believe that he has grown up and he's been chosen to represent our country.
That's why on February 11th, the Bats sent the Yawneys and the parents of the other Canadian Olympic athletes to Calgary to see their sons and daughters make them and their country proud.
We've seen him play so many times, but now it matters so much.
Well, Canada just about scored again, but Hašek made a save. Meanwhile, we get ready for a face-off deep in Canada's end of the rink. Canada with a 4-2 lead. There you see Hampshire, who wins the face-off. And Sherbin drops it to Zarly Zalewski. Tries to clear it up. Held in by Herdina. Shot wide of the target. Ruzicka centered, but intercepted by Gregg. He missed Berry with the pass, and Horshuda. Well, stolen by Berry, and Horshuda had to upend him. And he's going to get a penalty here.
Well, there's Berry again. And the puck seems to be following him around a lot here. He got around the defenseman. Horshuda had no real choice except to haul him down or give up the breakaway. So Berry draws a penalty.
He was in cold turkey. You know, sometimes the puck comes on your stick as a defenseman. You know you got somebody bearing down on you, and when you go to pass it, here's the Edmonton play. Edmonton uses this a lot, and the defenseman passes it to Sherbin, who come off the boards, wants to save off the mask by Hašek. I'll tell you what, greatest invention for the world for this game for goaltenders. The helmet, the face mask.
Penalty is for tripping to Horshuda. Canada on a power play. Canada scored a power play goal in this game. Here's Roy. The hand shot. Back to Roy. Into the corner. Cambolini trying to center. Now Yaremchuk in the corner. Back of the net for Schreiber to Yaremchuk. To Hampshire, return to Yaremchuk. Other point to Roy. Glove save Hasek, even though the shot was going to be wide of the net.
Serge Roy, who has been with this team for 3 years now, although he did take a break. He went to the Sweden, as we look at Bob Johnson, who is head of the U.S. Olympic program, wondering in what direction I'm sure his program is going to take over the next 4 years. It has been a failure. I don't think there's any doubt about that. The people in the United States think that the national team program that Canada has is probably a much better one. But their basic selection system from top to bottom, from coach right down to the players, needs an overhaul.
Here's Tambellini on a face-off with Pashek. 1:35 left in portion of his penalty as Czechoslovakia cleared down the ice. Hampshire giving it to Roy. Roy feeding Schreiber. Schreiber ridden into the corner, and Leva comes up with the puck and shot it away. Hampshire has to hustle back. Shot it to the Czechoslovak blue line. Sherbon over to Staviana. Feeds it to Leva. Here's Igor Leva with Pasha. Now just dropped it back to center to Sherbon. Now to Staviana. He shot it to Herdina, but that's a two-line offside pass. Yuri Herdina headed for the Calgary Flames, but has had a disappointing Olympics run.
Well, right up there in the middle of that crowd is Otto Jelinek. Fitness and amateur sports. We're going to be talking to him in the next intermission. They, of course, made an announcement that we're going to extend the program up to 1996. And I think that's good news. I mean, this is our national sport. This is our participation in this tournament is very important. You're not going to beat the Soviets unless you have a miracle. But I still think we should be there and we should be represented. And I think these men represent us by doing their best.
Here's Bochic breaking a rush up, cleared it back to center. Still 35 seconds left in Horshava's penalty. Chris Felix in control. Giving it to Bradley, number 8. Back to Felix, but Herdina intercepts and shot it away. Brent Yanni back for Canada. Here's Bradley, number 8 for Canada. Got it into center ice, but knocked back in by Baynock. And now Felix again. Dubois there. He's checked, and here's Herdina for Czechoslovakia. Penalized player back on for Czechoslovakia. Canada with Bradley back the other way. And it's broken up and shot back out into center ice. Here's Herdina picking it up. Zalapski rides him into the corner. Herdina back of the net, but Gregg comes up with it and cleared the zone for Canada.
Well, not much happening out there, and it looks like Canada now with a 2-goal lead are just starting to settle back and protect right now. 4-2. It's Canada over Czechoslovakia.
Beside the fact that the Chevrolet Beretta GT is one of the most aerodynamically designed cars in the world. And beside the fact that all this style starts at just $14,600, the Beretta GT goes like stink.
Faceoff going to be in Canada's end of the rink, 9:57. Left in the second period. Canada with a 4-2 lead. The fans start to whoop it up here at the Saddle Dome as Merlin Malinowski steps in for this faceoff against Flock. Malinowski and Flock jab away at each other with their sticks.
Malinowski, right after this tournament, goes back to Switzerland to play for Longnau in their playoffs.
He just won the faceoff. Roy to Poplinski. Now to Karpin. Only Bainock back. Karpin, backhander. And Hasek came out and made a pad save and now freezes the puck at the side of his goal.
There's a guy who plays a pretty tough, solid game of hockey, Vaughn Karpin, who is on his second turn with the Olympic team from the Paw, Manitoba, only returnee from 1984. Tried out with the Flyers in 1984 after the Olympic tournament, didn't make it, went back to university, and now is back with the Olympic team program. He's gone through the wars, Brad. Look at that nose.
It doesn't feel bad now, but wait to get up in the morning and you take a good look at it.
Malinowski steps in against Flock for this faceoff now in Czechoslovakia's end of the rink. Canada win the draw. Waters pinching in. Got into the corner, but Czechoslovakia take over there. Bainock into center ice to Flock. Ahead to Lala. Backhander and Mold just got a piece of that with his stick and then it went off to the corner. Canada clear it. Here's Poplinski. Ridden out of the play. And back comes Czechoslovakia. Polk. Now Flock picks up the loose puck. Into Polk. Shoots. Blocked by Roy. And puck comes to center ice where Uvira, number 8, has it. Canada controlling at their own line. Here's Poplinski. Runs into the defenseman back there who was blocked. Now Sherbin trying to center, but Flock gets it again. And now a penalty coming up against Canada as Hampshire upends Uvira, and I think they're both going to get penalties. We'll be right back.
Sometimes the most memorable part of a dining experience can be not too pleasant.
Your check.
At Swiss Chalet.
Welcome to Swiss Chalet.
There's pride in making every part of your visit a success. Our chicken broils slowly over real hardwood charcoal. The taste is unique. You'll feel you got more than your money's worth.
That was great.
Your check.
At Swiss Chalet, we treat every visit like your first because we want you back.
Swiss Chalet, there's always value in a visit.
Penalty on the play, Hampshire for cross-checking. 11-13 the time, Canada with a 4-2 lead, but Czechoslovakia with a chance here on the power play.
Well, just a straight act of bad discipline on the part of Hampshire. Totally unnecessary penalty, and I think Dave King's a little unhappy.
Czechoslovakia working it into center ice to number 10. Rochal, he drops it to Horshava. Horshava to Herdina, leaving it there. Rozicka leaves it for Horshava. Now they work it into Rozicka. And now the play is called on an offside, a delayed whistle, by the way.
All right, watch Hapscheid on this play. Now he takes a bump. That's a solid check. Nothing wrong with that. Now he threatens the cross check, and now he throws it at him. A little extra help there, but from the Czechoslovak player and the way he went down. But, I mean, that's totally unnecessary. And this is the kind of thing that over the years has cost Canadian teams hockey tournaments in Europe. You have to hold your temper. And may I say that, for the most part, Canada has done that. That's one of the reasons why, and we're not dealing with some goon hockey club out here, the least penalized team in the tournament. But, you know, you're in a close hockey game. You don't want to get penalties like that.
Here comes Berry for Canada. Couldn't get it centered. And Pashek takes over. Over to Bolshik. Czechoslovakia with 1:05 left in Hampshire's penalty. Pashek leaves it there for Bainock. He gives it to Sheba. Sheba fanned on it as he went to shoot. And that allows Berry to clear it down the ice. Number 28, Bolshik. To Pashek at center. Now to Leba. Number 11, Igor Leba. To Pashek. Good play by Schreiber to break it up and shoot it up. 35 seconds left in the penalty. 7:18 left in the period, which is the second. And Canada with a 4-2 lead. Czechoslovakia with number 22, Sheva. Knocked down by Trendiani, and Waters comes up with the puck and cleared it out of there. Oh, there's a puck that bounces up and hits Waters in the face. Play going right on. The referee doesn't stop play. Centered.
Well, the play, puck has to turn over, Dan.
Tim Waters still down in the ice, now getting up. And play still going on.
Fans don't understand the rule. The puck must come to Canadian hands before they can blow the whistle.
Well, Waters finally gets off of there. Shot in, and Moe goes back to the net and says, if you won't stop play, I will.
Well, as I say, the rule is the rule, and I agree with the rule. Now, they're arguing the point. Lind is explaining it to them, but there must be a turnover. You can't just stop play with the other team holding the puck.
This Harbeck kid looks good to me, Bob.
That was the darling of the fans this year. Look at that fluid motion towards the Ricoh laser printer.
Yeah, and watch this move coming up on that Ricoh copier.
Yes, remember, he was all swivel chair in college.
He does know his office equipment.
His teammates call him Mr. Copier. There's why.
Hold on, Bob. He's attempting to fax one document to three cities. Whoa!
Whoa, wait a second. There's a 360 and another. And another. What a show!
I'm looking for a perfect score on
That'll
this, Bob.
That'll endear him to the fans forever. Oh, that's going to cost him.
Judges. Well, the scores aren't too bad. Maybe I'll Ricoh this year.
Tim Waters being attended to at Team Canada's bench appears to be cut in the face.
Puck came up on him and hit him in the face. He went down. It was a long time there without the whistle, of course.
Meanwhile, Canada now back at full strength and leading 4-2. Here's Hrdina for Czechoslovakia. Drop pass to Ruzicka, back to Hrdina in front. They score! Ruzicka and Hrdina combining beautifully, and that cuts Canada's lead to 4-3.
Well, it appeared that whole business shook Canada up. They were not prepared, and Czechoslovakia marched right in and scored the goal. Ruzicka, that's a nice little play.
Nice give and go. Watch this pass back. Just under the toe of the goaltender's stick. Watch it. We'll get another look at it, I'm sure. But the Canada gave up the blue line to Hrdina. He dropped it through his legs to Ruzicka, back to Hrdina, back to Ruzicka. And Bogan went under the toe of his stick and went by him. A beautiful passing play. Here's where Waters gets hit by the puck, just deflects up and catches him in the face. And he's down and gives the, basically give the Czechs a 5-on-3 power play for about 20 seconds.
Now back to the live action. Ruzicka, his fourth of the Olympics, from Hrdina at 13:50. The scoring play. Canada now with a one-goal lead as Gregg shoots it down the ice. Hustling back, Beinock. Canada got to it first. It's onside. They try and center. But now Czechoslovakia with number 23. Holt coming into block number 27. Golapski tied him up. And back goes Ken Berry to get the puck. Berry over into the other corner to Sherbin. Held in by Czechoslovakia. Moe back of the net. And as you can do in international play, this freezes the puck in behind the goal. Canada with a slim 4-3 lead. We'll be right back.
I really want this house.
A Royal Bank report on prearranged mortgages and how they help home buyers avoid running around in circles.
Hi. Hello. Nice to meet you.
With a prearranged Royal Bank mortgage, home buyers know in advance what they can borrow, what their payments will be, and the price range they should be considering. And the interest rate is guaranteed in writing for 60 days. It can make all the difference.
We'll get it. Don't worry.
Royal Bank prearranged mortgages.
There you see the time remaining. 5:24 left in the second period. 4-3 now, Canada leading. Czechoslovakia cannot win a medal. Canada must win to keep their hopes alive. And right now they're leading 4-3. We don't have 6/100ths of a second in this business, but this is as slim a lead as you can get.
Canada has been, for the most part, pretty much in control of this game. What they have to do is just keep their cool about them. They're still playing with a lead.
Now Staviana trying to wrestle down one of the Canadians. Here's Sheba into center ice for Sherbon, leaving it for Leba. And over comes Yanni to knock him on the seat of his pants. And then to make sure, he just lay on top of him, and the puck was underneath both.
Well, Trent Yanni is a former defensive partner in junior hockey with Wendell Clark. And yes, I said defensive partner, because in Saskatoon, Wendell Clark was a defenseman. To Chicago Blackhawks as a draft choice, but went back to Saskatchewan for one more year, then tried out in Finland. And the Blackhawks themselves suggested Bobby Pulford and company that he come to the national team program with Canada. And I think he's really prospered there. He's played 120 games versus European teams in 3 years, 58 times against the Soviets, and if that doesn't help you, nothing will. That's pretty good development.
Very. And he's headed, by the way, to Chicago. According to my sources, I don't know if he signed a contract or agreed to terms.
He says he hasn't even been contacted, although Bobby Pulford is here. I'm sure his agent's been contacted. But he'll do well, Brad, I think, in the NHL. I think he's that kind of a defenseman that will step into the league and not hurt a team immediately.
I think he will, too. I think if there's one thing that European hockey teaches a defenseman is to look around and try and pick up the people without the puck to find out who's the most dangerous. That's the toughest thing for any defenseman going into the National Hockey League, is to look and read the situation that's coming at you so you can make the right decision. In European hockey, when you play against them, you have got to learn to do that if you're going to function well.
Here's Zuvira into center ice to Herdina. They left it for Ruzicka. Now they drop it back to Horshava, number four. Horshava. Knocked down but cleared to center. Zalapski has it for Canada. Back to Randy Gregg. Canada protecting a 4-3 lead here. Zalapski shot it down the ice. Horshava going back to get it. And that's icing against Canada. Canada still leading 4-3. We'll be right back to the Saddle Dome.
Now until February 27th, an event of great magnitude will touch every man, woman, and child in this country. The waiting is over. Let the sale begin. Flying colors. A sale so great, it's out of this world.
Face off in Canada's zone. Here's Lala, number 20, centered, but Trent Yanni was there for Canada. Yanni trying to flip it out on the boards. Bainok pinching in for Czechoslovakia, but Yanni intercepted that. He's driven out of the play by Flock. Czechoslovakia trying to hold possession. Malinowski now pinned in against the boards by Lala. Now cleared to Karpin. He can't get it out. Twice, Bainok has held it in at that point. Now Karpin does finally fight his way inch by inch out of the zone and then fell on top of the puck, and we get a stoppage.
Well, there's Joyce over on the far side pushing against Fulk up against the boards, number 23. Bothered by a bad knee, missed Volkaz. There's Joyce. Joyce, as we said, been in and out of the lineup a little bit, but played well here tonight. He's a Boston draft choice, as Dan mentioned. Could sign a contract with the Bruins. They've already got Craig Janney from the United States on the way to Boston. Maybe a tough team to crack the way they're playing this year.
Here's Canada with Randy Gregg. Clearing it to the Czechoslovak blue line. Shot out and then carried in by Boisvert. And it's whistled down on an offside.
Igor Leba, another Flames draft choice. Fifth round, 1983. But as we mentioned, the Flames not too eager to bring him in. He's had good games with them. He's a quick type of forward. But perhaps not too good in the tough going.
Buck comes back to Staviana, who's also a Calgary draft choice. Now to number seven, Sherbon. Now Leva couldn't clear it. Here's Bradley, back of the net to Schreiber. Out in front. Waver was there, but the goaltender Hasek came across, intercepted the pass out, and then just froze it.
Well, now, you mentioned Staviana. That's a different kettle of fish. I think the Flames wouldn't mind having Staviana on their team if they could get him. He's a top top defenseman in Czechoslovakia last year, as we look at Jan Štajzi. Go to the hole. Until then, score. That's the chant you get in Czechoslovakia at hockey games. That's their version of Go Canada Go, or Shai Boo, as they say in Soviet Union.
Here's Herdina, and the play is offside at Canada's blue line. 2:50 to play in the period.
That looks like a predetermined play out there off the face of it. Here's Herdina, Calgary bound, but
he's staying right here. I think he's probably got an apartment by now.
You know, it's interesting. The goal that Sherman got in this period was a predetermined play off the faceoff, a wraparound. Ken Berry jumped out of Habscheid to Sherman, and the Czechs just used one off that faceoff where, boom, Sheba took off, and the pass was going off the boards to him already. A little strategy marketing going here.
Zalapski shoots at the center. Horsheba knocking it down. Cleared it in, and Zalapski gets it back into center ice, and here comes Sherman. Scored Sherman. Herdina blocked his pass out. Now back to the net, onto the other boards. Habscheid hits the referee before Berry could get to it. And Herdina feeds Rosho off his skate. Zalapski for Canada, right back the other way. Zarly Zalapski. Horsheba pulled him down, and he'll get a penalty. And Canada will have a power play. Our CTV coverage will continue after this message.
From the East Coast or the West Coast, from Toronto or Inuvik, we can fly you to more destinations in Canada than any other airline. We've created the most extensive network this country has ever seen. Together with our partners, we offer you over 900 well-timed departures every business day. Because we have a name to live up to.
Horsheba gets a holding penalty, 17:50 the time. And Canada with a one-goal lead on a power play now, but from the faceoff, Czechoslovakia cleared. Roy held it in. Over to Felix, into Schreiber, stick save by Hasek. Schreiber again, trying to get it to Bradley. Now Roy at the point. Into Bradley. Fired it across. Felix had come in. Into the other corner to Bradley. Back to Roy. To Felix. To Roy. To Bradley. Jute, stick save again by Hasek. Now Schreiber back of the net. Comes to Chris Felix. To Serge Roy. Shooting, and that's wide of the target. Good puck control here by Canada on this power play. Bradley back of the net. Side of the goal to Boisvert. To Roy. To Felix. Into Boisvert to Roy. Shot trickles through. Poked at. Still loose in front, and coming up with it and clearing it out of there was Folk for Czechoslovakia.
Well, good power play again. Canada's looked its best in this tournament on the power plays they put up against Czechoslovakia.
Here's Leva trying to hit Pasek with a long pass. Moog out of the goal. Now cleared it. Leva intercepts. Leva for Czechoslovakia. They're shorthanded. 28 seconds left in the penalty. And here's Roy to Yaremchuk. Ken Yaremchuk lost it, and Leva right back the other way. Leva shoots one. That was deflected at a stick save by Moog. Zalapski, and out of Yaremchuk. Ahead for Tambellini. Tambellini shoots off the blocker of Hasek, and then a rebound try by Habscheid. But Hasek able to cover up. Just 1 second now left in Horsheba's penalty.
Well, Canada has had three good scoring chances on this power play. Here's the play. He took the shot on the net. He had a man coming late. And right there was Habscheid right at the side of the net off the Yaremchuk shot.
There's a look at it from behind the net. And Hasek doing a good job of blocking it, then getting to his feet and shutting things down by the post.
1 second left in the penalty, 11 seconds left in the period. Canada with a 4-3 lead. Canada goals by Roy, Joyce, Berry, and Sherbin. Stavjana, Sheba, and Ruzicka have scored for Czechoslovakia. Hampshire against Pashek. Hampshire to Yaremchuk. Now Horshev is back on. Here's Yaremchuk to Hampshire, trying to stuff it in on a backhander. Save made and cleared out of there by Czechoslovakia as the second period comes to an end. And after two, Canada with a 4-3 lead in a game they must win to stay alive for a bronze medal. Canada 4, Czechoslovakia 3 after 2. Here's Dan Matheson.
Thank you, Dan Kelly. All that action, of course, at the Saddle Dome tonight. At the same venue, it will be Witt, Thomas, and Manley. And you can watch the women's figure skating long program live here on CTV. More coverage right after this.
Quality personal care products.
The last we heard from the Kiska, Italy's Alberto Tomba was on his way to his second gold medal in the men's slalom. For confirmation, let's go to Mount Allen right now. Al McCann and Steve Piborski.
Well, Dan, it happened. Alberto Tombo did win his second gold medal for Italy, but that wasn't the only story that we had here at Nikiska today, Steve Podborski. Jungle Jim Hunter's old record of being the best Canadian finisher in the slalom with 19th, that was blown away today.
It sure was. Bad luck for Jim Reid, but for Alain Villard, a superb run. If he puts two runs like that together, he'll be able to crank off, I think, a medal in our next games.
Well, I hope so. Let's have a look at the way we called the runs when they actually happened. Have a look.
Go.
Our first Canadian in the second run of the slalom event is Alain Villard of Saint-Adèle, Quebec, and he'll give it his best shot, Steve.
He sure will. He's got a big gap ahead of him, over 3 seconds he has to make up if he wants to get in the medals. I don't think that's what his aim is today. They want to have a good, respectable time, get experience in the Olympics here this year, and the 1992 in Albertville, France, try and come out and get Canada's first Olympic medals in slalom and GS for men.
He was in 22nd place after the first run of this morning.
And he's skiing very well here. As it happened this morning, the course deteriorated quite rapidly, even throughout the first seat. And Alain is having an excellent run so far. A little bit sideways here, but this part of the course, Jim Hunter told us earlier, is like a glacier. And it's going to take a strong skier, and he's doing very well to make it all the way down to the finish.
But make it he does in 49-44, and he moves up to 15th place with a total time of 1:43.77.
And that was a superb run. 15th place is excellent for our Canadians.
Okay, in the starting gate, we have Jim Reid from Canada, Calgary, 25 years old. And were you crazy Canucks kind of put downhill on the map for Canada? These young guys like Villard and Reid are putting technical skiing back on the map, and good prospect for the future.
There's no question about that. It's a long and difficult road for a slalom skier. There are so many good people out there. Many more nations contest slalom and GS skiing, the technical events, and they do it in downhill. And these guys are blazing a trail and doing a very fine job. In fact, he's had a great time. He's only 4/10 out. He's in striking distance of an excellent run.
25th place after the first run for Jim Reid.
And Jim is really pulling it all the stops here. If he makes it all the way down, he'll have a great run. The crowd is behind him. We're all behind him. Let's just see him dance all the way to the finish. And he's dropped his pole, and it threw
tough
him off too
luck.
Much. Tough luck
tough
there.
Tough luck, Jim. Oh.
That was too bad. He was having a very strong run, but just right on the limit of his technique, and you just saw him get a little bit riled, a little bit rattly. He hit the gate too hard. It pushed him out of the course, and that's one of the problems with skiing these days is the gates are in the way, and they kind of tend to knock you off your line and off balance.
CTV's coverage of the 15th Olympic Winter Games continues in just a moment.
Nous avons demandé à Ronald Caron comment il avait perçu son nouvel entraîneur.
For the 1988 Winter Olympic Games in the Calgary-Nikiska area, and I guess although there were a lot of stars, the outstanding individual has to be Tomba, because Tomba won two gold medals for Italy. They're only two gold, Steve, and they've got to be really happy with him.
Certainly, he was quite a star, really an excellent performer and a great showing. We wouldn't want to forget Frank Vrindel in silver and Paul Frommelt with his wonderful bronze medal. Three very happy ski racers today.
You know, a resurgence for Austria in the men's alpine. They had six medals, three gold, three silver, shades of the 1970s, but Switzerland won the day. They had nine medals, would you believe? They really are a dominant force. But our Canadians are coming, believe me, and our girls did awfully well, as you know. I hope you enjoyed the alpine skiing events. Let's go back to Dan Matheson.
Thanks very much, and may I double what Steve Podgorski said about our skiers. Good show. We go back to the saddle dome when we return, and a special guest. Stay with us on CTV.
Well, Canada is still in the lead 4-3 over Czechoslovakia as we wait the beginning of the third period of this hockey game. A pleasure to have in the studios Federal Sports Minister Otto Jelinek, who perhaps can comment for us on a release just given us prior to the game, the fact that the national team program is going to be extended through to the 1994 period. I think it's a fine program. This comes under your jurisdiction because you fund both the CAHA and Hockey Canada. Tell us a little bit about the decision.
Well, I think it's a very important decision because I think the program is tremendously important to hockey in Canada. And regardless of how our team does here, and all the guys are giving all of themselves, as we saw just in the first two periods of this game and previous games, they've made Canada very proud. They've had a lot of other successes internationally, the Izvestia tournament, the fact that they create a tremendous incentive for the youth of this nation to participate in sport, deserve continued recognition and continued support of the Olympic program. So I think it's a major step in the right direction, and I hope that we'll be able to sit down with Hockey Canada and the CAHA, both of which organizations we fund, as you know, and make some even some other changes, such as I believe it's important that the Olympic team, the national team, gets an opportunity to participate in world championships. I think that's very important so that the team gets to know the other teams that they'll be competing in against at the Olympic Games, and that wasn't the case in the past.
You've been pretty outspoken about the NHL participation, the lack of it, the failure by the NHL to recognize the program. Do you feel it's realistic? Do you feel that there is a possibility that they could?
I think it's unfortunate that the NHL wouldn't see fit to adjust their program in such a way as to allow all the players to participate for their respective countries, because really the Olympic Games becomes a farce. The only major country that has their full team participating in these games is the Soviet Union. The other teams all have, the other countries all have members of their national teams in the NHL, whether it's the Czechs, who have 10 players in the NHL, the Swedes have 20 players in the NHL, and of course Canada has to put up a bunch of guys under the tremendous direction of Dave King. I mean, Dave's done such a wonderful job that this whole team, this whole Olympic program, the reason it's going ahead is because they've created a situation around the world where Canadian hockey has once more become very respected and admired by all the people from around the world.
Otto, when you mentioned the National Hockey League, they come back with the fact that to break up their league for the period of the Olympics, it cost them about $10 million a week or whatever it is. What's your answer to that?
Well, of course, that's what Siegler told me, that give me $10 million a week of taxpayers' money and we'll gladly take 2-week hiatus. We never considered using tax money to subsidize the NHL if they took a 2-week period, but I think that the NHL should still consider, for the betterment of hockey, international hockey, change every 4 years, a change in scheduling. I don't think that it's such a disaster. I mean, there's a lot of time in the before and after to make up for that 2-week period, and I think that I would hope that the NHL would still reconsider, because otherwise these Olympics, and as far as hockey is concerned, is a farce. The Soviets are the only ones here playing with the full team.
Okay, Otto, thank you very much for joining us, and this will be an ongoing thing as we move along. All right, after two periods then, Canada leads by one. We'll be back with the third period in a moment.
There are few guarantees.
Now back to the action at hand, and we're going to get a penalty against Czechoslovakia. Uvira, who just about had one prior to that last whistle, now does get a penalty. And Canada, with a 4-3 lead, will go on a power play. Uvira to the penalty box.
There's a look at Uvira, who got a little mix-up in the corner just before play started. The Czechs have had better scoring opportunities even in this period. They had an early chance in this period in the first minute and putting a little more pressure on Canada. I would have to say they've got some momentum going right now, but they're going to have to come up with some big opportunities here in order to kill off this power play for Canada.
Canada 1-for-4 on their power play today. Puck comes into center ice. Habshaid over to Roy. Back to Habshaid. Now Roy to Habshaid. Now to Bradley. Bradley shoots it in. Hasek out of the net to clear it. Schreiber gets a rough ride on the boards from Bochic. In goes Bradley to try and drop it back, does to Hampshire. To Roy, banned on it. Now Roy again. Bad save by Hasek. Hampshire for Canada. Canada on a power play. Now Bradley's been injured. He goes to the bench here. Off the bench, Tambellini. Hasek, pad save as he slid across. And back comes Plock. Plock now just circling back. Gives it to Staviana. He moves in. Staviana for Czechoslovakia. Couldn't get the shot away. And Serge Boisvert feeds it into center ice. Here's Ken Berry. Into number 11, Tambellini. Round on the boards to Yaremchuk. Berry checked by, or at least Canada hold it in. Now Felix shot, sliding up, blocking it was Beinock, and he covered up on it, and we get a stoppage in play, and Beinock is shaken up on the play. Bradley, meanwhile, at the Bradley. Bench.
On the bench, he picked up a stick, I think, in the mouth area down in the corner on that power play. The Czechs are playing very, very physical. That last shot that Tambellini had on the net, both Schreiber, watch in front here, Schreiber and Boisvert both get mugged in front of the net by the Czechs, playing very, very physical hockey. This could ignite something here in the third period.
41 seconds left in the penalty to Uvira. Canada with Tambellini, Berry, and Yaremchuk up front. Felix and Yanni, the point man. Czechoslovakia's Sherbon. Felix held it in. Now it's Hasek in center ice. He and Felix battle. Pass to Leva. And going back to get it is Tambellini. To Trent Yanni for Canada. Leaving it for Felix. Felix had his pass go off a skate, and Hasek back the other way. Offside as Leva broke in ahead of the play on left wing.
Well, there's Pradošek Pospešil, a great defenseman, former captain of Czechoslovakia. You might remember in the first Canada Cup, that Czechoslovakian team that wound up in the playoffs against Canada. He was the captain of that club. Guy Charron, assistant coach with Team Canada, along with Tom Watt, under Dave King. I have to echo what Otto Jelinek said during the intermission. The job that Dave King has done with his team is immense. He has got the optimum use of the talent available. His kids have been disciplined. They've played well. They've won an Izvestia trophy.
And they're battling to get a bronze medal here at the Olympics. Here's Bob Joyce cutting in. Good play by Beinock to break it up. Now Czechoslovakia at full strength. Puck held in by Randy Gregg. Shoots from the point. Up high, another penalty coming up here against Czechoslovakia. Zalapski shot it in, and now as Bochic gets the puck, a penalty call and a hooking call against Czechoslovakia. We'll be right back.
Mom said I could stay. What's for dinner?
Chicken and broccolis.
Broccolis? They're good for you, Joey.
Chances on the power play. First a shot from the point, and then Bradley on the rebound. And Hasek came across and made an excellent save.
Well, Canada's power play is clicking in this game. They're getting the offensive chances that weren't there earlier in the tournament.
One of the reasons they've moved Hampshire to a point position today. He's out there now on the left point, Roy on the right point. Schreiber now trying to center. Here's Bradley into the corner. Drops it to Boisvert. Serge Boisvert to Roy. Shooting, blocked at the defense. And back comes number 27, Plock. Missed a check from Roy. Hampshire for Canada, giving it to Roy. Roy over onto the wing for Bradley. He's skated out by Herdina now. Boisvert to Hampshire. Back to Serge Boisvert. Shoots wide of the target. And that puck will go all the way back into Canada's zone. Any explanation as to why Canada's power play has been So much improved today, Brad?
Well, I think you hit the nail on the head moving Habscheid back there. You know, you look at the Canadian defenseman, and Habscheid will move the puck and make the better pass because of being a centerman than the Canadian defenseman. So if you've got an extra guy out there that's going to handle the puck better than what they had in the past, he's also not afraid to go in and keep four men in around the net, which is going to create a lot of problems.
Still 30 seconds left in Czechoslovakia's penalty. Here's Trantiani getting it to Gord Sherbin. Sherbin now just dumps it in. In comes Yaremchuk for Trantiani. Back of the net to Berry. Out in front, Sherbin there. Oh, and then shooting it wide of the open net was Yaremchuk from a bad angle. Sherbin to Felix at the point. Into Yaremchuk. Now the penalized player back on, and there's Hasek diving back of the net to cover up, and then some sticks go up off to the side, and we get a stoppage in play. We'll be right back on CTV.
I was new in town, kept hearing I'm going to Harvey's, and I've been to Harvey's. I wanted to meet this fella, sounded real popular.
Heard Nina stick handling through. Moves in, shoots off the blocker of Moog and into the corner. Into the other corner for Zalewski. Rochal in to take him out. Kicks the puck to Herdina. Randy Gregg knocks Herdina off the puck. Rochal and Zalewski still battling in the corner. Here's Herdina. Back on the point. Boshika shot. Quick save there by Moog. And back comes Carpen, number 19, just shooting it in. Boshika back to touch it. That's Lacey against Canada. The CTV Olympic coverage continues after this pause.
She was 6 when this was taken.
The only photo of a missing child.
That's all that we have.
I mean, there's a lot of good hitting going on right now, all the way through since the last period.
Canada with a 4-3 lead. Canada must win and hope for West Germany to beat Sweden tomorrow if Canada is to win a bronze medal. And that's the most they can win in these Olympics.
Well, it'll be a first medal since 1968 if, in fact, it materializes. And in 1968, it was also a bronze medal. And again, it was a key game against Czechoslovakia that allowed Canada to get that bronze medal. But as Canada was in control of its own fate in 1968, here they need some help. Big help.
And they first have to win this one today, which they lead 4-3. Here's Poplinski. Couldn't get anywhere. And Lala comes back for Czechoslovakia to Ruzicka. Back to Rochal, and a diving check by Gregg to break it up. Now centered in Moog, cleared it away. Rochal to Ruzicka. Moog again got a stick on it, and it's cleared out of there. Horsheva has to chase back. Into center ice, it's Ruzicka, and that's a two-line offside pass. Our CTV coverage of the Winter Olympics continues after this.
This here's the story about how clever I am. You see, one day I got to thinking about making myself the perfect hamburger, all juicy and char-broiled, topped just the way I like it. Well, here's the clever part. I realized it'd be a whole lot less taxing to let Harvey's make that hamburger for me, seeing as how their specialty is making perfect hamburgers and mine's eating them.
Because you can get it just the way you want at Harvey's restaurant.
It was a beautiful experience.
Play just underway. Czechoslovakia trying to move out of their own zone. Here's Leva, who had that big chance earlier. Cutting in. Igor Leva centered. Knocked away in front of the net by Boisvert and now carried out of there by Bob Joyce. Joyce has Boisvert with him. Joyce still with the puck in front. Bradley a whack at it. Now diving to hold it in with Serge Roy. Centered, backhander by Boisvert, just wide. Hasek for Czechoslovakia. Trying to get away from some tough checking of Brian Bradley. And now they wind up in a heap. And And we get a stoppage in play with 11:09 to play. There's Brian Bradley on loan to the Olympic team from the Calgary Flames.
And Serge Roy, who gave us a second and a third effort in this one, which got a bit of an ovation from the fans. Joyce getting it out. There's the shot. And here's Roy diving in and just blocking that one. That's a dangerous play. He felt he could make it successfully, and that paved the way to a Serge Boisvert scoring chance.
Those are the decisions, the plays you want to make when you're down, not when you're up.
Faceoff won by Hampshire. Roy at the point. Shot blocked. Canada again with Barry's shot, but Oshak handles that. And then it's cleared up by Czechoslovakia. Here's Waters back to get it. Jim Waters. Cut in the face back in the second period, but back out seeing regular duty in the third. There's number 23, Folk for Czechoslovakia. Taken out, and Canada's going to get a penalty on the play here. Crowd can't believe it. Serge Roy will get a penalty. Neither can I. Now Hasek shaken up as this delayed penalty. Hasek trying to get to the bench. Beauchamp now being tied up by Berry. And they drop it back in their own zone for Flock. He dropped it to Bainock. Now Czechoslovakia trying to carry in is Sheba. And now finally Waters comes up with the puck. And now the delayed holding penalty against Serge Roy. Czechoslovak power play coming right up.
There's heart in this land. It's there in all we do. That's why hands across this country reach for the blue. And when we get together, it's a taste that's clean and true. So when you call,
when you call,
then you call for the blue.
You know it's gonna be blue. That's why you call for the blue.
Dave King's not very pleased with what is going on out here. I wouldn't be pleased either. Now, the stick is up in there. Whether there's holding or not, that's a very, very debatable situation. One of those penalties you could second-guess all night long.
Czechoslovakia on a power play. Herdina, side of the net. Ruzicka can't center, and Zalewski. Where did Horshava held it in? Now Herdina. Moving in, shoots one off the defenseman and into the corner. Ruzicka to Herdina. Back to Horshava. Return to Herdina. Ruzicka sliding back to break it up was Greg. Zalewski cleared it, but again, Horshava, good play to hold it in. To Pashak. Blocked by Karpin. Now Rosho. To Pashak. To Horshava. Into Herdina. Side of the net to Ruzicka, and Zalewski intercepts, and Zalewski cleared it, but up too high and put it over the glass, and we'll get a faceoff in Canada's end of the ring.
Well, they've done everything but get the puck out of their own zone. They keep getting it back, and Zalewski is upset at himself, and rightfully so. Could have picked the middle lane, that's second guessing, but even then he picked it up, trying to clear it off the glass, just shot it too high.
Well, the one thing, you know, when you're killing a penalty as a defenseman, all of a sudden you end up with the puck. The ideal place to do or shoot the puck is aim at the blue line that's on the board, about a foot off the ice. If you can shoot a wrist the puck at that blue line that's going up the side of the board, about a foot off the ice, there is not a defenseman in the world that's going to get that one.
Still a minute three left in.
Let's go, boys. Come on now. Pick it up.
Canada's penalty to Roy. Czechoslovakia 0 for 5 in the power play today. 16 for 40 in the tournament.
That was Yanni who was heading to the bench, I think, for just a last-minute instruction from Dave King on the way to take this faceoff. Another important one. Less than 10 minutes left.
It's Pashak against Hampshire. Czechoslovakia come up with it. Here's Staviana. But Trent Yanni there to clear it up. And Bainock has to chase back for Czechoslovakia. Still 48 seconds left in the penalty. Here comes Igor Leba. off the boards for Baynock, and that's offside at Canada's blue line.
Well, Czechoslovakia really hasn't mounted too much of an offense in this, although they've had some territorial advantage. They've really been running around the perimeter, Brad, and it's a kind of an interesting box that Canada set up in that you like to talk about the tight box. It seemed to be a little looser and a little more spread out towards the line.
Well, it's that you keep them on the perimeter. It's an open box where, because the Czechs are not sending anybody in front of the net, then you don't have your key on the other people and let them move it around. The quicker they move, they might be able to catch it. They move it very, very quickly, but the Czechs aren't even doing that.
Here's Boisvert clearing it down the ice. Damiana bumped by Boisvert. But coming out the other side is number 22, Sheba. He shoots it down the ice, but hustling in is Poshek, so there's no icing. Boisvert back to get it, and he backhands it high down the ice. Here's Scaviana ahead to Poshek to Sheba. Whoop, save move, but a short side shot. And he held onto it, and then Greg and Sheba take a push at each other.
Well, the last four excellent scoring chances in this game have all been Czechoslovakian. Radina, Poshek that went off the faceoff, Leba on the breakaway, and here's Sheba with a chance on a good, solid wrist shot. And the glove save there by Moog.
Sure,
it looked a lot easier than I think it was.
Well, that was a good wrist shot. But I liked the little Poshek, that little redirection at the blue line, a classic move because he had Sheba going full speed. All he did was just turn his blade of his stick and redirect it over to him. And a little thing like that can throw a defenseman off. It really can, or any defender.
Czechoslovakia, 5 seconds left in the penalty. Horshava's shot off a stick and up into the crowd. And now the penalty is expired to Serge Roy. We'll be right back for the final minutes of this game.
Page 5, headings. He wants them bolder.
Check.
Presenting personal publishing with the IBM Personal System 2.
Page 7, artwork, smaller. No, bigger.
Well, make up my mind, will you?
Oh, no!
What?
The bonuses.
Oh, that was worth a shot.
Everything your business needs.
Okay, print it.
To create quality documents, in-house, on short notice.
I'd like you to make a few changes.
Personal publishing with the IBM Personal System 2.
Back to the live action as Malinowski moved in for Canada. His shot wide of the net and back the other way, Czechoslovakia. But a good play by Sherman at his own blue line to clear it up. Here's Horshava shooting it in, and Randy Gregg back for Team Canada. Canada just clear it out into center ice. Ubira has it there, number 8. For Herdina. Now to Horshava. 7 minutes, 25 seconds left. Canada with a 4-3 lead. Canada must win to stay alive for a bronze medal. Here's Rosho. Dropping it to Baynock. Pass save on the short side by Moog. Baynock tried to center. Greg comes up with it. And here comes Bradley out of his own zone to Sherman. Sherman moves in. They score! Gord Sherman!
He shanked the shot, Brad. Not much of a goal from a goaltender's standpoint, but it looked like he hit the ice and then the puck, and it just didn't go as fast as the goaltender thought it would. Watch the stick as it makes contact with the puck.
Oh, the puck's rolling. That's what happened. And it almost dipped. It started in the air and dipped on Hoshark. He kicked the right pad out, but it caught him on the underneath part and trickled back into the net. A big goal for Canada by Gord Sherman.
Here comes Boisvert for Canada. To Bradley, now to Schreiber. Canada with a 2-goal lead. Here's Boisvert. Poshek a save on the short side, and he held on to it. Sherman is third of the tournament, his second of this game. From Bradley and Greg, the scoring play at 12:59. Here it is again.
Watch it just hit the inside of Hasek's right pad and bounce through his legs. A big goal. That puck was on the corner, and Hasek threw out the right leg, but I think because it was rolling or spinning, it dipped on him a little bit and went under the pad.
Big, big goal.
Indeed. 6:40 to play. Here's Canada again trying to center. Back comes Lala for Czechoslovakia. Trying to move it in, does to Folk. Trying to center, Moog slid across. Locked off the short side and was able to freeze it. Our CTV coverage continues after this.
Sometimes the most memorable part of a dining experience can be not too pleasant.
Your check.
At Swiss Chalet.
Welcome to Swiss Chalet.
There's pride in making every part of your visit a success. Our chicken broils slowly over real hardwood charcoal. The taste is unique. You'll feel you got more than your money's worth.
That was great.
Your check?
At Swiss Chalet, we treat every visit like your first because we want you back.
Swiss Chalet, there's always value in a visit.
Ron Roosh and Brad Park, Dan Kelly at the Saddle Dome in Calgary. Canada with a two-goal lead. We're down to 6:16 to play. Canada shooting it into center ice. Stavjana passes to Sheba, who shoots it in. And Felix is back for Canada. Chris Felix able to clear it up. Gerbon chasing back. Now Stavjana into center ice, and here comes Poshek. Very dangerous for Czechoslovakia to Sheba. Other side, Moog diving save to Rob Leva. Leva can't believe the save Moog just made.
That's two this period, and Leva's going to go out and hang himself or something. The breakaway and a diving glove save by Moog earlier in the period. He just did it to him again.
Well, that's his best of the game, maybe of the tournament.
Well, I'll tell you, he sure looks like a first-round draft pick for Pittsburgh for me. Watch this save. He's playing the shooter. The pass goes across. There goes Moog. All right, what a shortstop. I love it.
Had it all the way, says Andy.
Here's a shortstop play. Down the third baseline, either one.
That's the way we used to do it in Penticton on the road, he says. What a stop. 5:48 left. 5-3 Canada. Here's Poplinski getting it out of there.
Andy.
Here's Horshava for Czechoslovakia. Moving in. Slides it into the corner. Herdina. Tied up by Greg. Greg and Herdina continue the fight. Comes to Uvira at the point. His shot, Moog back of the net. Sets it up for Greg. And Greg got it out of the zone. Here's Malinowski. Upended. No penalty, says the referee. Shell Lind had a tripping infraction right in front of him. And he signals safe.
They do that in Europe. I don't know what he was looking at, though.
Well, there was one before there. Randy Gregg had upset Verdina just before that. And he shook his head, so this one he wanted to make perfectly clear.
Look at Oshek back to the net. Canada leads by two, less than 5 minutes to play.
Calgary. The hotels are packed, the restaurants crowded, and 40 Royal Bank branches are ready for anything.
A Royal Bank report from Calgary.
The Royals started planning for this years before the first Olympic visitors arrived. Out-of-town employees are standing by in case extra help is needed. Automated payroll services are in place for companies like ABC Television, here to cover the games for U.S. viewers. A Royal Bank language hotline has been organized to provide translation services. Personal touch banking machines with cross-Canada Interact connections are now also linked to a major U.S. network and programmed to accept bank cards from around the world. And arrangements were made long ago to store the most coveted awards in international sport in this Royal Bank vault. The people, the resources, the flexibility to respond to any challenge. That's the Royal. Proud to be appointed the official bank of the 15th Olympic Winter Games.
3:58 to play. Canada leading 5-3. Here's Roy for Canada on the attack and firing it in, but he put it up too high and it goes up over the glass and into the crowd. Well, we've mentioned that Canada must win this game today to keep alive their bronze medal chances.
Well, what happens is Canada would move into a tie for second place with Finland, but it's not really a tie because Canada lost to Finland in the tournament, but Sweden would be yet to play its final game, and Sweden's just a point behind Canada. And of course, Finland has a game against the Soviet Union. You could wind up in a three-way tie for second place in the tournament if Sweden were to tie its game against West Germany. You'd go into tiebreakers, and that's another facet we haven't discussed. And we'll probably, when we get a final score here, we'll be able to tell you the rest of the things that can happen tomorrow in the final round of this tournament.
Here's Herdina. Trying to shoot it in. Moe got to the goal. To Zalapski, nice little bank off the boards, and now Karpin taken out by Flock, but he got it out of the zone, and then it's shot back in offside. And we're seeing some old NHL-style hitting in this one, Brad.
I'll tell you what, it may be a big rink, but they're getting to one another out there. Von Karpin just took a hit from Flock there. He was reaching. I think that probably his helmet came down and cut him right on the nose. But he was reaching for the puck, and Flock wasn't going for the puck. He was going for Karpin, and he nailed him.
3:31 left. Canada 5, Czechoslovakia 3.
We're talking about goals for and against. The interesting thing is when we go into tomorrow's games, Sweden is -2. The Soviets did Canada a big favor by walking all over Sweden yesterday. And they're -2 in the goals for and against. While Canada is even going into this game, right now they are +2 in the goals for and against. So Sweden, when we get into this business tomorrow, it could be a three. As I say, there's a possibility of a three-way tiebreaker in there.
Well, I've never heard of such a complicated system anyway, so.
Well, it's always like this in tournament play. Going back to 64 when they concocted this whole system.
Well, it's a little more so this year, though, with carrying your points into the medal round of only teams that are in the medal round counting.
Well, that's not new either. The three teams from each division going in the medal round, that's the new part, and that's complicated it.
Here's a chance for Czechoslovakia. Herdina just missed a tip-in try. And Canada able to clear it out. Horsheva back after it. Over to Block. Broken up by Canada and cleared down the ice by Boisvert. And Cherbon goes back to get it. Round onto the boards. Canada feeding it into center ice. Here's Prentiani into Boisvert. He's checked and blocked. Gives it to Pashek. Dusan Pashek, number 21. Trying to go around Prentiani, centered. Nobody there to get it. And Canada quickly clear it out of there, but as Schreiber shot it out, he shot it up over the glass. 2:24 still to play in this game.
She was 6 when this was taken.
The only photo of a missing child.
That's all that we have.
Don't worry. This way, please.
What does she look like today?
There you go, Betty. She'll take care of it.
In an experimental project with the Metro Toronto Police, technology from IBM is helping age their pictures.
She's got fangs.
It used to take me 80 hours to draw this.
Where was it developed?
Now it only takes 30 minutes.
It's her.
Yeah.
In Canada, by IBM.
With Ron Roosh and Brad Park, Dan Kelly at the Olympic Saddle Dome. Canada 5, Czechoslovakia 3. A game that Canada had to win to stay alive in their bronze medal hopes. Loose puck back of the net. Waters able to clear it out. Gerbon couldn't hold it in, and here is Leba. To Staviana, now they work it back to Leba. Leba was the guy that will be shaking his head for a couple of days after that diving save that Mold made up. We're in the final 2 minutes, folks. Staviana to Leba. Canada noted for its defense, and that's what they'll have to play right now to protect this two-goal lead and put the pressure on Sweden tomorrow in their game against West Germany. Here's Pashek coming back. Pashek into Leba. Center to Staviana, moved in, and Waters broke it up. Now Cherbon. Had a shot blocked by Sherbin. Gerbon into the corner. Tim Waters back to get it. Hampshire's going to get a penalty as he upended Shaba in front of the net. 1:20 to play. Canada's going to be shorthanded. We'll be right back.
While the country is going to sleep, Purolator Courier is hard at work. 7,000 Canadian employees working from 84 terminals across Canada, all dedicated to fast, dependable delivery of your packages virtually anywhere in Canada and the world. No other courier can match the scope and service of Purolator Courier. Why waste time with anyone else? Call us.
We just got a penalty on that last play to Mark Hampshire. Interference, the call. 18:40 the time. So Canada with a two-goal lead, but going to have to play shorthanded. Now Czechoslovakia calls a timeout. Starshee will go over some strategy. They need a couple of goals. Meanwhile, a tie is not going to help Canada. They need a win.
Well, they need the win, and I think they're in pretty good shape in that department. But, you know, you don't want to get another goal scored against you now because of that plus-minus situation. At this moment, going into two games tomorrow, now Canada has played one more game. Canada and Czechoslovakia have played one more game than the other four teams in the medal round. In the goals for and against situation, Finland is plus 7, Canada is plus 2, Sweden is minus 2. So if we get in a tie-break situation, in other words, Sweden winds up in a tie tomorrow and we wind up in a three-way tie, Canada would get a medal and Sweden would be out. Finland would get the silver, Canada would get the bronze. So Sweden must win tomorrow. Again, their game against West Germany. They cannot settle for a tie.
We'll have two games for you tomorrow. The West German-Sweden game on the air at 10 o'clock Calgary time, 12 o'clock Eastern time, and then in the afternoon, Finland and the Soviet Union.
Now, if Soviet Union were to beat Finland by 8 goals, it'll be something by 5 goals, Canada could get a silver, believe it or not. Now, this is if there's a three-way tie. In other words, if Sweden ties tomorrow.
Here's Zalapski trying to clear it out. Horshaba held it in. And then it's fired down the ice by Canada's Ken Berry. Now Czechoslovakia on a power play, and they have their goaltender off as well. 6 attackers. And on a power play, they trail by 2. Here's Herdina. Zalapski has them tied up. Now Shaba in the corner.
Canada should get a goal here. Try and get a goal. Add another one to that plus minus.
Here's Brzezicka to Horshaba. Shooting. Oh, got a stick on that drive. That was labeled from the point. And now a four-man jam up in the corner. We get a stoppage and we're down to 39 seconds left.
Well, it's getting curiouser and curiouser, to quote one Lewis Carroll. But it is really strange the way this one's going to shake down tomorrow. And as I said, if Canada now has to think first of preventing a goal, but secondly, with an opportunity, go for it. Help yourself in the plus-minus department.
I think the Czechs are really relishing this chance to be a spoiler here. They're really, in all, being logically, they can't win the hockey game. They can't get a medal, but they're going to pull their goaltender and see if they can spoil the Canadians' chance.
39 seconds left. Canada with a 5-3 lead. Poplinski ties up Ruzicka. Now back of the net, Shaba trying to center. Comes back to Ruzicka. Zalapski took him out. Now Herdina to Pashak. Over to Horshaba. Back to Pashak. Shot off a stick into the corner. Poplinski back to backhand it to the line. Now poked out of there on a good play by Sherbin. Just 12 seconds. Loose puck in the open net. They score! Sherbin with 9 seconds left, and Canada gets a 6-3 lead.
There are some people in Sweden right now that are really upset at Czechoslovakia. There may be a few people in Finland upset at Czechoslovakia.
Watch Gord Sherman here as he chips it out. Watch this effort. Him and Horschbaugh are going to collide for the puck. Where sticks come together, but Sherman wins the race, chips it, and it slides down. That's Gord Sherman's third goal for a hat trick. A great individual effort by Gord Sherman.
Kent comes with 9 seconds left. Dave King says, that's okay. We're still alive. Sherman's third goal of this game is fourth of the tournament, and Canada still alive as this game winds down. The final score is going to be Canada 6 and Czechoslovakia 3. And there's one of the key figures in this victory, goaltender Andy Moe. A good performance by Canada in its final game of this tournament, and they get a standing ovation here at the Olympic Saddledome.
Well, look at Canada in this tournament. They tied the defending world champions from Sweden. They defeat Czechoslovakia 6-3. They had the tough game against Finland. That was the one they're always going to look back at, especially if they fail to get a medal. But Canada comes up with a 6-3 victory, and they're still alive.
And we'll have more of that for you tomorrow. 12 o'clock Eastern time, we'll have the Sweden-West German game. Final score here today, Canada 6. Czechoslovakia 3, Canada still alive.
I was new in town, kept hearing I'm going to Harvey's and I've been to Harvey's. I wanted to meet this fella, sounded real popular. When suddenly I saw people topping these big juicy charbroiled burgers, having them this way and that way. Everybody looking real pleased about the entire situation. Well, I never did meet Harvey, but I sure found out why everybody was a-coming and a-going from his place.
'Cause you can get it just the way you want at Harvey's restaurant.
It was a beautiful sight.
So that's the hockey game. There have also been two medal events go in the books so far today. Italy's Alberto Tombo won the men's slalom, his second gold. The Soviets, East Germans, and Finns running 1-2-3 have been shut out so far today, but Sweden has moved into fourth place in the standings as Gundersvall won gold in cross-country skiing. Now, in less than 2 hours' time, a shootout at the Saddledome where the weapons will not be speed and strength, but grace and technique and coolness of nerve. This is Canada's Elizabeth Manley. If she can hold it together, she's in the medals tonight against Katharina Witt and Debbie Thomas, 1-2 in the world in figure skating. We'll also have the women's 1,000 as Karen Kania, speed skater extraordinaire, looks for her 7th Olympic medal.
TV Television Network presentation from Calgary, Alberta. The 15th Olympic Winter Games, brought to you by IBM Canada Limited, partners in Olympic performance. By Purolator Courier, when it's just got to get there. And by Swiss Chalet, for chicken and ribs, there's always value in a visit. This is the CTV Television Network.
If you know the value of these,
then you know the value of these.
And these.
Then you can afford these.
Why pay retail?
Why pay retail?
Why pay retail? Why pay retail?
Why pay retail when you can shop at Clarence Port? 2450 Lancaster Road, open Sundays.
Just east of the Canadian Rockies is a place where people will go faster and fly farther than ever before. The place is Canada.
TV television. television network presentation from Calgary, Alberta. The 15th Olympic Winter Games, brought to you by Royal Bank, appointed official bank of the 15th Olympic Winter Games. Harvey's. Harvey's makes your hamburger a beautiful thing. And by Gillette, manufacturers of quality personal care products.
If you were watching last night on CTV, it was supposed to be the Battle of the Carmens. From East Germany, the elegant, the beautiful, the graceful Katharina Witt against American Debbie Thomas, the athlete. Well, somebody stole the show. Somebody came out of third place and skated better than anyone else. A little Canadian from Ottawa by the name of Elizabeth Mammon. Here's John Esau.
What a dramatic ladies' championship it was as the gold medal went to Katharina Witt of East Germany, only the second lady ever to win back-to-back golds. But Elizabeth Manley really shook up the audience and all of the country by coming through and winning the long...
hands, tell them just how big they are.
I'm with Mickey Jones.
Of Debbie Thomas.